Very quick, 4-0 scoring pass in dangerous role for my Aunt Jamie to call on. Surprised
I thought that little
I don't believe small fry slowed down at all as James started to whistle.
Like
We had a late hit there on number 15. MK19. Looks like MK initiated a hit on Harley Spin after that fourth whistle. That is not legal. Jam with both jammers finishing their time in the penalty box. So jammers can start in the box and still get lead. It's only when they get the penalty during the jam that they lose their eligibility. So it's going to be a race for both of these jammers. Undead working a strong defense, trying to buy some time for Harley Spin to complete that initial. That earlier penalty, Lizzie Von Lethal. Making the hit, but a high block is assessed to number three, no pucks given. So that's going to send Southern Delaware's jammer to the box one more time and give a power jam to Harley Spin. Maintaining full speed around the track. Now here she comes again. gas and small fry all gone from the outside. Being rescheduled and new games popping up, so stay on top of everything going on in the community. You can find them on Facebook at Pittsburgh Roller Derby, and on Instagram at Pittsburgh Roller Derby Undead, with underscore marks between all of those words. They are also on Twitter.
And guess what? We're on TikTok too.
I have not actually downloaded that to my phone.
Posting them on our social site. Visit video
number 8 REO Mean Wagon, jamming for Pittsburgh on a power start. Oh, here's the ZomBees getting the other team. REO Mean Wagon is our lead jammer.
Something.
a possible backlog call on one of the undead skaters in regards to possibly pushing somebody in the back to gain relative position. As you know, any contact the back of the opponent is not legal. After our referees got together, they decided that the contact had occurred, but was actually to the side, not in the target zone for backlog, so no penalty will be issued, and we'll have long step review. This time, followed by the Pittsburgh Undead in regards to what they thought might have been a backlog by one of the other Delaware skaters, but once again, the actual impact did not occur to what would give a backlog, so that will be lost, no penalty will be issued.
Oh,
Both of our favorites coming out at scoring fast with 4 points. We are still Jammer on Jammer. It's a foot race. Bay Clotter now getting stuck behind the Pittsburgh's defensive wall. Breaking up that record you're having of Jammer on Jammer. Corey.
Clotter finally able to take this reserve guy off his feet. Is able to break free the pack, but Bruce Chris picks up 4 points and I'll let them down.
Our track maintenance team. I know Squishy's out there taking care of the track on the outside line. Unsung heroes of Derby. Now that the track has been fixed, our jam can continue. That's number 28, Lizzie Marlino taking down 440, double treble. Officials currently discussing what kind of pizza they'll be having at the after party. Once they come to a decision, we'll get our next jig underway.
They may also be discussing if they're going to bowl or axe throw at the Paradise Bowl.
Both, I mean, enjoyable. I wonder if you could do both at the same time.
That could be bowl with one hand and throw an axe with the other.
Or just throw an axe down the bowling alley. I feel like there's a liability involved.
There's definitely a liability down there. That would be impressive, though, if you could throw an axe the entire length of the bowling alley and get a try.
I don't know if I want to give them ideas. Okay. We are currently jammer on jammer now with the Mad Hatter in control. Both of our jammers trying to find their path to the pack.
Get together, Black.
Captain Kitty Black. hitting Megan Clocker just as the whole attack against him.
Laying up point number 9-11 coming out versus 101 Bruce Cruise. And we are doing another old fashioned headline start. Coming out to jam now for the Zombies, number 141 Whiskey Business taking on Double Treble once again offering a jam for Southern Delaware. Coming back in from an earlier jammer penalty. Jammer is coming back out of We are looking at a tentative score right now of Southern Delaware 162 and Pittsburgh 216, but our Denver referees have to meet with our scorekeeper to make sure everything looks good, so this is not yet a final score.
While we're waiting on that final score,
we are still waiting on this official score by our referees, but give a big round of applause to both of our teams who played this game and made it possible. Our officials, our volunteers, our photographers, our EMTs, and your announcers, and the Southern Delaware for making the trek all the way from Delaware to Pittsburgh for this game. Always be worse.
Central Flower, Pennsylvania is a road town.
It's a state treaty.
And join us on September 3rd, the Zombies will be playing again against the Plan B. That'll be a mixed-up team. And September 24th, the upset will be taking on Chicago's Brothers.
Relatable. We promise there will be a victory lap here as soon as on the flip side of that, we can guarantee that the scoring and the points will be accurate after everything is totaled up and we have the final score, and we have a final score when it comes around. We are waiting on that oh-so-official rolling whistle that we hear. Thank you. There should be some kind of entertainment here while we're waiting for this. Possibly a skater dance on the track. They're not even listening to us. I think we lost them. Guarantee they're still talking about throwing axes. For that whistle. To be number 8, REO Mean Wagon. Please claim your cup. This is a cup full of candy. I think some of these cups have peach rings and some have sour gummy bears. MVP Hammer for the Zombies, number 101, Bruce Cruz. They know the right and wrong way to do it, so we've also got our after party occurring as soon as we are out of here.
Thank you, Zombies!
That will be at Paradise Island Bowl, 7601 Grand Avenue. I believe you can come out of here and just make a left, and it is down that way.